We're all alone, no chaperone can get our number. The world's in slumber, let's misbehave. There's something wild about you, child, that's so contagious. Let's be outrageous, let's misbehave. When Adam won Eve's hand, he wouldn't stand for teasing.
Still trying. The number one cooking show on public access. Yeah. Today we've got Crazy Henry demonstrating a wonderful pasta with a side of mussolini.
If you'd be oh so sweet and only meal to feed, dear, 'twould be the great event of 1928, dear. They say that bears have love affairs and even camels were only mammals.
Let's misbehave, let's misbehave. We're only mammals. Let's misbehave.
Bob, do you know who wrote that song?
Cole Porter.
Yes, you.
Who else?
Yes. Well, as Bob said, welcome to our show. And I have a surprise for you, Bob, in just a few minutes, but I'd like you to do a song first.
Oh, okay. Let's do one from Harold Arlen.
Okay.
Who wrote The Wizard of Oz and so many of our great popular songs.
Yeah.
Sure.
Well,
he wrote the music for The Wizard of Oz. That's right.
I wonder if they call him Harry, because I was named after my Uncle Harry.
Really? I thought you were named after your grandfather.
Oh, yeah. Yes, I was named after my father's father. My real name is Grandpa. That's right.
No.
Harold Arlen wrote this one when he was writing the shows for the Cotton Club up in Harlem. Yeah. Let's fall in love. Why shouldn't we fall in love? Now is the time for it while we're still young. Now why be afraid of it? I said let's close our eyes and make our own paradise. Little we know of it, still we can try to make a go of it. We might have been meant for each other. To be or not to be, let our hearts discover. Let's fall in love. Why shouldn't we fall in love? Now is the time while we're young. Let's fall in love. Let's hear that trombone. Like Crazy Henry anymore. Maybe it's better.
We might have been meant for each other. To be or not to be, let our hearts discover. Let's fall in love. Why shouldn't we fall in love? Now is the time while we're young. Let's fall in love.
How about this one?
Hello, Central, give me Dr. Jazz.
Ooh, as opposed to Dr. Jazz.
He's got what I need, I say hey.
Yeah.
When the world goes round and I've got the blues, he's that man that makes me get out both my dancing shoes. Well, the more I get, the more I want it seems. The man that gets me fixed. Hello, Central. Give me Dr. Jazz. Play that banjo. Seems I page old Dr. J.
jazz in all my dreams. When I'm troubled, bound, and mixed, he's the man that gets me fixed. Hello, Central. Give me Dr. Jazz.
All right. How old is that song?
Oh, that song is from the 1920s. So that song is about 90 years old, which is about the same age as your liver.
That's right.
Now, if you look at your screen, I hope you're looking at your screen, you can see the what they call the URL for the Banjo Bob Crazy Henry website.
What is URL?
It means where they can get us on the internet, and I used to know what it means. But anyway, it's our website.
If anyone in our audience knows what URL is, just shout it up.
Yes.
Caroline, you know what URL is?
All right. Well, I know what
it
is.
Does Caroline speak English? I don't know.
Banjo Bob.
Some,
since our last show, someone actually wrote down the URL, looked it up, and found my snail mail address, and not only sent me a letter, sent me a gift for you.
A gift for un petit moi?
Let me read the letter.
This is a surprise to me.
Okay. Dear Banjo Bob and Crazy Henry.
Okay.
I love your show. I love when Bob sings Elvis Presley songs. The problem is Bob doesn't look like Elvis. Gee, they noticed. Now it says, I have enclosed a gift for Bob to help him look more like Elvis, but only when he sings songs made famous by the King of Rock and Roll. Sincerely yours, Barbara Nolan. Yes. So, let me show you the gift. This is really something.
Going to help me look like Elvis?
Yes. Look, Bob, take a look at this.
It's an Elvis wig.
Yes. This is just what you need, Bob.
Oh, boy.
I don't know whether it's frontwards or backwards.
I don't know if it'll fit over my already lush hair.
Here, see if you try it on and see.
Let's see how it goes.
Don't leave it on the floor. People think it's a tarantula.
Get it.
Yes.
I don't know how it goes.
Well, just try.
Wait a minute.
Oh, it's you.
Wait, let me put my collar up like Elvis. Yeah. Well, thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen. Yeah.
All right. It's you.
Let's do an Elvis.
You got Bob?
Yes.
Sideburn. You have to fix it.
Oh, a sideburn?
Yeah,
the sideburn is...
The sideburns are not supposed to look like puppy dogs.
Oh.
Here you go.
We don't know about any of our viewers at home, but if you're having a good time, but we're having a good time here.
Okay.
All right. Thank you, ladies and gentlemen. Yeah. I'm going to sing this song for my dear, sweet Priscilla Blue. You know I can be found sitting on all alone. You can't come around. Well, then at least please telephone. Don't be cruel to a heart that's true. Maybe if I made you mad, something I might have said. Please let's forget my past. The future looks bright ahead. Don't be cruel to a heart that's true. Well, I don't want no other love. Baby, it's still you I'm thinking of. Let's walk up to the preacher, tell him yes I do. Then you'll know you have me, and I'll know that I have you. Don't be cruel to a heart that's true. Why should we be apart? I really love you, baby, cross my heart. I don't be cruel to a heart that's true. Don't be cruel to a heart that's true. I don't want no other love. Baby, it's still you I'm thinking of. Yeah.
You look just like him.
He was always mad. I'd like to point out that when Elvis Presley was my age, he had been dead for 20 years. That's not an easy thing to face. gee, maybe I better keep this on all the time. Yeah, well, right now? I don't know.
Well, it looked...
Oh, he'd better go in, like, during a break or something and fix it, because...
It's such a disappointment when you take it off.
But with the curls, I look like Hasidim.
Hasidim.
Yeah, exactly.
I see them come and I see them go.
Oh. All right.
Okay, well, thank you, Barbara, for sending that in.
All right. I am going to do a song from the 1890s.
Wow.
In case any of our people...
Oh, a modern song. You do songs from the 90s. Oh, yeah. Wait, the 1890s. Let's hear.
A village maid was leaving home with tears. Her eyes were wet. Her mother was standing near the spot. The mother said, Naraja, dear, there's one thing you should know. That I'm the only mother you have got. The city is a wicked place, as anyone can tell, and cruel dangers round your path may whirl, your path may whirl. So every week, be sure to send your wages home to me, for heaven will protect the working girl. You are going far away, where I will no longer stay. In the city's giddy world, from temptations, crimes, and follies, villains, hansom cabs, and trolleys.
Now that's unnecessary.
Heaven will protect the working girl. Second verse.
Same as the first.
The dear old mother's words were true, for soon the poor girl met a man who on her ruin was intent. He treated her respectful, as those villains always do, and she supposed he was a perfect gent. But she frowned different when one night she went with him to dine into a restaurant so bright and gay. Then he said to her, after this, we'll have a demi-tasse. Then to him these brave words the girl did say, stand back, villain, go your way. Here I will no longer stay. Though you be a marquis or an earl, you may tempt the upper classes with your villainous demi-tasses. Heaven will protect the working girl. You don't hear songs like that anymore.
What was the name of that?
The name of the song was Heaven Will Protect the
Working Girl. Okay. I've never heard you do that before.
Well, you want to do songs we never did, so.
Well, you got a point. You got a point.
Okay. It's up to you, Banjo Bob. Go ahead.
Okay. Let's do From Duke Ellington.
All right.
All right. Who always said, love you madly, love you madly. Yes.
Cigarette holder. That wigs me over her shoulder. She digs me out cattle, my satin doll. Baby, shall we go? I'm flippin' Kevin Amigo. You're trippin', speaks Latin, my satin doll. Nobody's fool, but I'm playing it cool as can be. I'll give it a whirl, but I ain't for no girl catching me. Sweet Jeroony, a telephone number. Well, you go doing my rumble with Uno and that my satin doll.
Let's hear that orchestra.
Duke
Ellington.
Well, anyway, I was kidding about our website, the URL, but if you'd like to tell us what you think of the show, we'd be happy to hear.
Isn't life painful enough already? You're asking people how they like this show?
Why not?
Yeah. Why don't you give us some cooking tips or something?
That's why
I introduced it by mistake.
If I had any cooking tips, I would give them to you.
Yeah, turn on the stove.
Yeah, yeah.
Thaw first.
All right, why don't we do a ragtime number? Okay.
All right, to bring our music up to date?
Well, no, it's only because we haven't done a ragtime number
in a
long time.
Maybe it's better we haven't.
Yes. Right. This is a number that was the theme of the Joe Franklin TV show for many years.
Joe Franklin.
12th Street Rag.
Martin Paint. Legacy of Al Jolson. Ladies and gentlemen, Henry is now playing with his nose. Make up your own joke. Done, Winstead.
Thank you. I think, Bob, we should introduce our camera people.
Oh, okay. How about the guy in the middle?
Well, we have Missy on camera one.
Nice curtsy.
We have Lamont Cranston on camera two.
The Invisible Man.
And we have Sweet Caroline on camera three.
Yeah, Caroline's just lucky for you. No one's ever written a song about Caroline. Well, maybe except this one.
Caroline, I'll bet you, as long as you... Do you know who wrote... Sorry. That's all right. Destroy my genuine stratosphere.
Someone has to.
Yes. Caroline, I wonder if you know who wrote Sweet Caroline.
Neil Diamond?
I see that a lot of people think that. That's not true.
I thought Neil Diamond wrote that, too.
No.
Who wrote Sweet Caroline?
Walt Disney.
Walt Disney wrote Sweet Caroline? How would that sound? At the helium again.
Only kidding, Carol. You were right. It was Neil, what's his diamond?
See if you get any more time on her camera. She'll probably point at your shoes now.
Okay. All right. Now, I want to do a rock and roll song, but I also want to do a participation song so the people that out in the audience can participate. Yeah. So we're going to try and do both. I have
a song. Okay, what rock and roll song can people participate with?
That fateful night, the car was stalled along the mountain track. That was unnecessary.
That was the train, the railroad track.
Oh, I pulled you out and we were saved. But you went running back. Teen angel, can you hear me?
Oh, Bob, I got an idea.
What?
When we get the teenager, can you hear me?
Teen angel.
That's right. Yeah. Teen angel, can you? We'll get everybody to go to point to their ears. Teen angel, can you hear me?
Yeah.
And then we'll go, teen angel, can you see me? Are you somewhere up above? And am I still your own true love? We'll grab our hearts.
So the first thing is you put your fingers up to your ears. Our audience will keep them in there.
All right, Bob, all right. I'll let you do it. Let's do the chorus.
That fateful night, the car was stalled along the railroad track.
Ooh! Ooh!
I pulled you out and we were saved, But you went running back. Teen Angel, can you hear me? Teen Angel, can you see me?
Thank you, Caroline.
Are you somewhere up above?
Caroline, that's the wrong finger.
No, it's not.
And am I still your own true love? Just sweet 16, and now you're gone. They carried you away. I'll never kiss your lips again.
That disgusting.
They buried you today. Teen Angel, can you hear me? Teen Angel, can you see me? Are you somewhere up above? And am I still your own true love?
Oh, that is so dramatic. But I was watching the monitor, and when you put your hand up, you got a big stain under your arm. Don't do that again.
Bob.
Yeah, don't do that. Looks bad, you know what I mean?
Okay, we need a peppy song.
Yeah. We need a new act.
That's true.
Yeah. But Caroline was nice enough to participate in that. And you, I miss you always do.
Oh, you know,
you're the greatest.
By the time
ever.
You see the show, this won't be current. But you know what just reopened after Superstorm Sandy?
What?
Coney Island.
Can you say that again?
Superstorm Sandy.
Now say supercalifragilisticexpialidocious.
No way. All right.
Goodbye, my Coney Island baby. Farewell, my own true love.
Farewell, my own true love.
I'm going to sail away and leave you. Never to see you any.
Never for to see you any.
I'm going to sail upon that ferry boat. Never to return. Coney Island.
So long.
Goodbye, my Coney Island.
Get out.
Goodbye, my Coney Island babe.
Island. I spent a lot of time down in Coney Island when I lived there.
That's right.
I didn't live in Coney Island, but I lived about 8 minutes away on the F train.
When we first started working together, you were living right on Gravesend Neck Road, as I recall.
On East 30th.
I mean, he was literally living in the road.
That's true, washing windshields, saying, you got a quarter? Anything.
Gravesend Avenue?
By Gravesend Neck Road on East 16th Street. Oh, no, right. That was another place. That was East 3rd Street. You don't really care, do you?
No. All right.
I only know two streets. I only know some streets in Brooklyn. I know where my parents grew up.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
21st Street and East 26th.
We never did grow up. That's why we're doing this.
All right. Banjo Bob, it's time for you to do a song.
Okay. Let's do another one from Duke Ellington.
Okay. Duke Ellington.
Love that guy.
She never treats me sweet and gentle the way she should. I got it bad, and that ain't good. My poor heart is sentimental, not made of wood. I got it bad, and that ain't good. But when the weekend's over and Monday rolls around, I end up like I start out, crying my eyes out. Lord above me, Maker love me the way she should. I got it back. That ain't good. Bridge. When the weekend's over, Monday rolls around, I end up like I start out, crying my eyes out. She don't love like I love her, nobody could. I got it bad, and that ain't good. I got it bad, and that ain't good. Yeah.
And a standing ovation from our camera workers. Wow, they don't have chairs.
When the midnight choo-choo leads for Alabama.
We always do it, we always do it.
When we are there,
really? Yes.
I've got my fare. When I see that rusty-haired conductor, I'll grab by the collar and I'll holler, Alabama, Alabama, that's where they stop the train.
For watching, everybody. You've been watching Crazy Henry and Banjo Bob. That's right. In Still Trying. Tune in same time next week, same time, same station. Don't be late.